everybody, Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop here, and welcome back to yet another episode of Orewell Zoo. As you've definitely noticed, it's been a while because I was working in Tharmashadi. Thanks again to Eben for that fantastic opportunity. But we're back in Orewell, and in the time I was absent from this project, I had a buddy of mine from Discord, his name is Juno, make what you can see in the distance. As I mentioned, I think it was the last episode, this was going to be a desert dome, and he came to me on Discord asking if he could do it, he sent me, one of his projects, which was, a recreation of the Toronto Zoo, and specifically the Indo-Malaya building, and I was just freaking floored by all of the detail he managed to cram in, all of the unexpected usage of different pieces that I would have never come up with, and I was like, absolutely, dude, come on in. Fuck shit up. It's gonna be great. And I can already tell he did a fantastic job from the screenshots he sent, and from what I can see from over here, for context, this is the proboscis monkey exhibit in our Indo-Malaya section. But we're gonna hop out of Tejid Cam and go check it out. Oh, this looks so good. So yeah, he did not just the Desert Dome, but also the Swamp exhibit, which is under the Desert Dome. And I wasn't necessarily not looking forward to doing this, but it was definitely going to be a big challenge, and he took so much off of my shoulders for doing this for me. I could not be more thankful. So yeah, it's thanks to Wyatt, but really the thanks is all from me, because what he did, it's fantastic. But we're going to check out all of this exterior stuff he did first. It looks like he used a lot of the Orewell object palette. So we had like these borders and the trash cans I made. Oh, we got a sign. Oh, this is the map. I totally forgot I made this. But yeah, this looks great. My folded umbrellas. And then, yeah, this is like a sort of specialty of his. Like just all of these tiny, tiny details that I would have never come up with. Like this ladder. It leads up to all of this air conditioning. This was something that really, really impressed me, was all of the HVAC stuff he does. And you probably, I didn't know what this was, because this is the Domez air conditioning set with the art shapes, but he made his own with the, if I can get out of G mode here, the Australia road signs. Let me just pick this apart. So yeah, he made his own HVAC set out of the road signs. I would have never come up with that. I'm too smooth-brained. I am just not of his level. I don't even know why he hit me up. He's so fantastic. So yeah, we got this ladder, and then if you hadn't already determined, this is directly based on the desert dome at the Henry Doorly Zoo, all the way down to this sort of rock wall thing that comes up in front. And yeah, we got a little restaurant here, off the grill. Did he make these? I wonder if he made these himself. I wouldn't be surprised, but they look really good either way. Orewell Zoo was definitely in need of more restaurants besides the one at the entrance, so this works fantastically. And then, yeah, I remember making these. Looks like he brought them over, which is perfect. Gets a good sort of consistent visual style throughout the whole zoo. And we'll pass the thankful rock and enter. Oh boy, this is so cool. Alright, what are deserts? He's crammed a ton of these little signs in here. And he did mention to me on Discord that every door does have something behind it, so I think we're gonna check this out first. Alright, we're going in here. Oh my god. It's so good. It's so good. I would have never had the patience or like the willpower to do any of this kind of detail in terms of backstage. Oh my god, he did security cameras. Oh my god, it's a little spoiler, we got some manatee stuff going on. This looks fantastic though, holy shit. So yeah, wow. Yeah, especially backstage detail is something I never have the time or patience to do, and he's already knocked it out of the park. This is already more detailed than anything in Orewell so far, but it's literally just getting started. So we'll pass through this neat little area. He's got like a little fire alarm button and some security cameras. And then we get into this sort of entrance pavilion thing. So we got the Sonoran, the Namib, and the Red Center. I don't know which one to do first. Yeah, and he's got so many of these custom signs in here. He's got all this text that if you want to read it, you can pause. It's fucking fantastic. Do we want to do the wetlands first? I would ask people if this was a stream, but this is a video. So I think we'll actually save the desert for last, because I've actually seen most of the wetlands. So we'll go down into the wetlands, presented by the Gherkin family. Very cool. He's got a sponsor there. Oh yeah, another door. Let's see what's behind it. Oh, nothing this time. I will check every door though, because I want to make sure. All right, Wetlands of Vanishing Kingdom, presented by the Gherkin family. Oh, and it's an elevator, okay. Is there anything in here? Yeah, of course there's an interior to the elevator. Why wouldn't he do that? I wouldn't. Oh, and it looks like, I'm gonna try to navigate this. There's like, oh, okay, you just go down the stairs. We're gonna go like that, and then come out the other end, and we're in the wetlands. Holy crap, two desert dome, get there. So we got all these little tanks up front. It's pretty cool. And then we'll enter this way. Oh, actually, I want to see what's behind here. All right, nothing. That's cool. I'll make sure, though. All right, we're going to look inside. Wow. All right, so we got this aviary. Some ibises, a bittern. We had a little chat about this, because when I was looking at it, I was like, wouldn't they need sunlight? But he told me they could use both supplements as well as ultraviolet light to make sure the birds were, like, okay in terms of lighting. I just wanted to make sure, but of course he had an answer for me. So birds of the swamp, we got boat-billed herons, shoebills. Birds help keep reptile and insect populations down. They also help pollinate and spread the seeds of many different plants to keep diversity high. That is so cool, dude. What I'm super impressed with is just how, like, compact everything is. Everything is so, like, I don't want to say claustrophobic, but it's super, like, just crammed in here, but it's cool in that way. That's like a compliment. Yes, we got boat-billed herons, Venezuelan trupial, sun bittern, snowy egret, Brazilian teal. This is so rad. Then we have another aviary on this side. I don't know if any of these are like walkthrough. I feel like some of them might be. And then we got our first animal. I don't know why we're on pause. We can press play. Orinoco crocodile, where we use the caimans in this case. This looks amazing. Alright, coming through here, we got more aviary stuff, and then the terrariums. These look insane. Oh my god, I love this. I'm sort of borrowing well, I don't say borrowing because I didn't invent it, but it's the same technique I use for mine where I literally slap an image up front. But it still looks fantastic though. Alright, and then we got the Wyatt-Andrews Manatee Cove. Dude, you did not have to name anything after me. I did not do anything in this build. I just sat back and you did all of the magic. But he did tell me this is the one area that he actually did lighting for, so we'll turn on night and slow please, because it's a manatee area. And I just want to stop and look at all of the different, like, textures. So we have, like, the beams, we have the rope on the beams, and then he used the tree roots to just add some, like, just extra, like, borderline gristle on the sides. It's fantastic. And then boom. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. This is easily my favorite part of the swamp section. Everything else is fantastic, but this just tickles every detailed bone in my body. Look at this. Oh, the lighting on the manatees and all of the different signage he managed to cram in here. Let me see if there's a door behind this or anything behind here. No, that's okay. But yeah, oh, it's so good. The lighting, the rocks. Another thing we talked about, I was wondering if this was too small for the manatees, but apparently the inspiration he used, which was the Cincinnati Zoo, this is basically the same size. It's like 300 square meters or something like that, which I guess makes sense since manatees are like pretty low metabolism, slow moving creatures. So they wouldn't really need like too much room. And I figure these guys are just rescues anyway, so they would, they're pool. Oh, here we go. Information. Here at the zoo, we are home to 3 West Indian manatees in the wetlands. Their pool is 4,079 square feet and is at most 5 meters deep. They live alongside multiple different species, including gars and river turtles. Cool. But yeah, manatees are pretty, like, slow-moving creatures, so I figure they wouldn't need, like, a whole, like, extensive, like, massive pool, like a cetacean might. But, it does continue back here, because we do have some backstage, of course. Look at this. He's got a hose. I didn't see this last time. It was still work in progress, but, ugh, I'm totally stealing these overhead lights with the, aquatic pack fences. I'm stealing everything, but that especially. Oh my god, it's so cool. And then it goes up here. I wonder if there's anything behind here. There is! Oh, it just keeps going. Oh my god. This is fucking insane, dude. Oh, I don't want to... That's Desert Dome stuff. I don't want to spoil that yet. Yeah, we'll come back down here. Wait, I want to check the other rooms. Okay, that one goes back out, so we have some backstage stuff. We got dumpsters, we got like an animal transport truck, all looking fantastic. Totally stealing these ladders. And then coming down through here, nice little window into the manatee holding shelter. Oh, this is so good. And we've got little carpets all over the place just to soak up all the water. And then he's got a filtration system. Of course he does. And yeah, I think this is all. That's all empty. But still, like, oh, it's so good. The detail. I aspire to this level of detail. This is absurd. It's ridiculous. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. All right. And coming back down through. Got more signage here. Manatees in danger. And then, okay, so that was one part. Oh yeah, the river otter exhibit. So we got some otters here. I actually just installed the North American river otter mod, so I'll probably be replacing these giant otters pretty soon. But they still look fantastic in here. Oh, so he actually did do lighting in here. Okay. So yeah, we'll just go back through again, because he did actually add some stuff in terms of lighting, because before it was it only worked in the daytime. But yeah, we got this little info area, from logs to bogs. Here at the zoo, we have many native species of the Everglades, including river otters, conservation efforts, beavers and manatees, wetlands diversity. And he definitely did all of this himself. That's not like a, well, he clearly made this himself, but like, he did do custom signage for this exhibit, which is super impressive. Yeah, it's all so fucking fantastic. Exhibit. This is the walkthrough aviary. Okay, so we have some birds through here. And then we got more views into the river otters. The giant otters look so funny here just because of how massive they are. I'll definitely probably be putting river otters in here when I film the cinematic, just so we can see how that looks. And then they, of course, have their own shelter in here. This looks so cool. I love all the different elevation changes, and I've never seen these before. These look cool. Like little hanging ball enrichment. I'll definitely be stealing that. And then, oh my god. It just keeps going. There's totally gonna be stuff I'll miss in this video, but yeah. Jesus Christ. And then back into the river otters. They do seem to use the water frequently, which is nice. And then I want to make sure I don't miss anything. Looks like we got... Okay, so that's up into the Desert Dome. I think we'll actually take the... If we can, we'll take the elevator. We'll just go back up, because I think that's how we came in. Oh, we're on the roof. Hold on. Let me find the elevator door. And we'll probably want to turn on day, because it's obviously a glass dome, so you're gonna be that's how you're gonna be looking at it. Okay, here we go. So yeah, that's how we came into the wetlands. And we'll come back through here. What are deserts? Deserts are disappearing. Alright. I've never seen any of this before, so this is genuine live reaction from Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop. So we got some terrariums coming through here. We're gonna squeeze through here. And holy shit. So we got turkey vultures. It's very cool. I figured they would be, their wings would be clipped. And I told him, he asked me, like, are we sure we want some of these exhibits to be small? And I was like, dude, just go all out in terms of, like, the outdatedness of the area, because it adds a ton of lore. And I really love how this came out, this custom sign. Turkey vulture, blah, blah, blah. So this is general information. But then he added actual lore to the zoo. So we have a pair of rescued turkey vultures named Ava and June. They were rescued off the coast of New Jersey, where they were found by the Avian Wildlife Center and then sent to live out the rest of their lives with us. Learn more about their stories here at orewellzoo.com/desertdomevultures. That is fantastic. I love it. Then we got some smaller, like, terrarium space here. I figured they would have, like, turtles and tortoises and some lizards in here. And then, I wonder what's supposed to be in here. It's so small. I love how small it is. People would definitely be upset about this now, but when they, like, built this in, like, I guess the early 90s, it would have been perfectly adequate for, I guess, like, either, like, a wildcat or a coati, maybe, because this is the Sonoran Desert area. And then coming through here, we have some more of these, like, really tiny terrariums. I love the barrels in here. That looks fantastic. It's really neat theming. I love how tight everything is. I would have never, oh, these are for rattlesnakes, the U.S. Bank Rattlesnake Canyon. Cool. Got a little sponsorship there. But yeah, I love how, like, cramped everything is. I would have never, like, had, like, the sort of bravery, so to speak, to make everything this sort of, like, intimate. We got a bobcat exhibit here. Also knows the red lynx. Here at the zoo, we have one lone male named Red. He was born at Balboa Zoo. A little remnant shout out there, where he spent 4 years of his life as a breeding male and father of two. As for days being a dad, he retired to spend the rest of his life in a simulated desert where he can relax. OrwellZoo.com, Desert Dome, Bobcat. Love it, love it. It's fantastic. And then we have their exhibit in here. It's super tiny. And then we got some more of these. And then an ocelot exhibit. And, oh yeah, this is super cool. So, this is the peccary exhibit up front, but then they have an ocelot exhibit behind it, so it's like a predator-prey display kind of deal. Oh, yeah, and then they have more in the sort of holding backstage area, because this would be woefully inefficient or insufficient if this was it, you know? But yeah, this looks fantastic. And then I think that's it for the Sonora section. I'm not sure what this is. It might be like keeper access, I guess. I'm not sure. Looks great, though. I'm sure he knows exactly what it is. Feel free to correct me in the comments, you know. And then this is the Red Center exhibit. So we have the... Oh, right. This is a walkthrough, I think. This is... they would have wallaby all over the place. And then they would have tawny frogmouth in here. I love the little aviary he's managed to fit. And then another fire alarm button. Super cool. This looks so freaking good. Then we have a kookaburra aviary right here. Coming through here. We got a little cave terrarium area. So we have all kinds of stuff. Very cool. And then coming through here. Ooh, interesting. We have a little pond. And then looks like we have what I assume would be birds in here. But, oh yeah, he used Just Goron sign for the mongoose exhibit. I love how vertical this is. It's cool. And then, what else? We have a small terrarium here. And then coming through here, we have Clip Springer and Nile Softshell Turtle. So I figure the turtles would be in here. And then, yeah, it's just so freaking impressive how much he managed to cram in. And then, I'm assuming this would be for fennec fox. I may move some of these logs out of the way just so the, oh wait, what? Let me look in here. Ooh, okay. Okay. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. So I've just discovered this whole backstage room. Oh my god, I love this. This might be my favorite detail of all of the different signs that they've been like reusing and have been damaged. So they've just sort of brought all of these to the backstage where no one can see them. And then this is the holding for the fennec foxes. And they would just come through this tunnel and out into their, I don't want to say yard, but their main exhibit. And then we've got Clipspringer and soft shells on this side. And then I assume there's something back here. Ooh, okay, this is just backstage. And then the sort of holding shelter for the Clipspringers would be implied. Cool. But yeah, this is a freaking tiny fennec fox exhibit. But, like I said, I did want to make sure some of the exhibits were pretty outdated just to add some sort of some age to this area. That's pretty important when you're building. And then moving on into the other African exhibits, we got, oh, this is the walkthrough aviary. Okay. So we got hooded oriole, quail. Oh, this is still Sonora, I think, because these are all North American birds. But then also we got the Cape Thickney and the blue-bellied roller, which I think are African. So it's fine, it's just different continents. I think he might have seen the species list and just sort of put all of the birds in one place, which is cool. And then we got this other aviary for, I guess, a bird that probably wouldn't be safe to keep with the others. And then we have a really tiny exhibit here, of course, with backstage. It's freaking nuts. I haven't even looked through all of this yet. Wow, 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 wow. And then over here, oh, this is into the bobcat exhibit. I gotcha. Very cool. All right. Oh, I'm getting a little lost here. There's so much detail getting lost in it. We have, like, this little thing. I'm not sure what that is, but it's great. It's great detail. I wouldn't have come up with it. And then in here, oh, okay, so whatever's in this exhibit. Oh, it says African wildcat. Very cool. And yeah, I wouldn't have been brave enough to like hide the gate so much. I would have had it like front and center, but he's like completely hidden it behind all these logs, and like of course the cats would be able to come through here, but I wouldn't have done that because because my brain is too smooth. His brain is very crunchy. that's why he's been able to do all of this. But this looks fantastic. It's got like little platforms for them to enjoy. It's freaking great. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. All right, and then we're back in the pavilion. This looks freaking fantastic. I just want to make sure there's nothing I missed. So we'll go back out the way we came. And then we have the entrance plaza. And then, we'll check out all of this stuff around. So we have backstage, more backstage. I don't want to like undersell any of this, but it's so freaking good. He's got a fire hydrant. He's got trucks going around. We got a whole service road. Oh, it's so good. Oh, okay, okay. So this is why there's a second gate, because you can actually come out this way. Interesting, interesting. Okay, so wetlands, and then so this would be, like, the other side. I gotcha. I'm trying to figure out where you could, like, get in through here. Okay, so you can... Oh, okay, this is the way I came in first. Okay, because we got the turkey vulture, and then this is the second gate entrance thing to the desert dome. I gotcha. I love the little, like, shade structure we got going on here. And I love, like, the like I mentioned at the beginning, the incorporation of all the different objects I've been using for Orewell. We got like these little bollards so vehicles can't come in. It's so fucking good, dude. You knocked it out of the park. We'll just do an overhead. I also want to see how this looks from above. Oh yeah, of course, we got like a whole HVAC system up here. So I figure, yeah, coming through here, this backstage building would be like a sort of central hub for the whole desert dome. And scrolling out, we have like this whole HVAC system here. There's like roof access, so you can come through here if you're a staff member, of course. Oh, it's so good. Oh, wait, what's... Oh, okay, this is the pond. it takes on like a whole new feel from above, because like inside it's like completely immersive. You can't see anything. And like once you're up here, it's like the illusion is gone, which is great because that's how zoos work. It's all like completely utilitarian until you reach the guest view, and it's like completely like immersive. I love it. All right, I'm just scrolling out. I don't want to miss anything. Oh, okay, I think these might be like sapling supports. I'm not sure. He'll tell me what these are, but it looks fantastic. It's so freaking good. And then I want to zoom out and see how this looks in relation to the rest of the zoo. But I also want to see what this thing is. So this is like just general. I think this is for power. This is like a power supply thing. And then he also did a fantastic job on all of these like supports. Oh, it's so good. And he built this from scratch, I think, because before I had just like slapped down a geodesic dome from the workshop. But he made his own, and it looks freaking incredible. So we're going to zoom out and see how it looks in relation to the rest of Orewell. It looks amazing, of course. Oh man, I can't wait to like build this up and just like the general like surrounding area. It's going to look so good, and I can't wait to see A, what he does next, and B, how Orwell's going to turn out with all of this. So thank you so much again to my buddy Juno. Follow him on the workshop. I'll have his link in the description. And right after this, I'll be recording another episode of Gold Coast Aquarium, because we have, I did a ton of stuff with the new signs and some of the animal mods. So I'll see you in whatever comes first, and have a good one.